Hello and welcome to my workshop. My name is Paul. I'm a luthier and bow maker based in Tasmania, Australia. In this series, I will share some of the projects I work on each week, giving you a glimpse over my shoulder as I work, as though you were looking through the window into my workshop. Okay, so now we're fitting a new set of pegs. We've got a few things. We've got our pegs. There's your French style ebony peg. Nice. I feel they're nice in the hand. They're really nicely made, made in Germany. And if you bought a set of pegs from your local violin shop, they obviously would not fit the holes in your violin. That's where we have a reamer and a matching peg cutter. So first up, we want to see how close the old peg holes are to our reamer sizes. This is the closest that I can get with my reamers. And you want to make sure that obviously you're also reaming the holes in the right direction. And then obviously you don't want to ream this one this way when it's supposed to be. So they're quite fit to the original. You want to remove as little material as possible, and you don't want to be too aggressive. Just see it's just starting to cut, and this is feeling much nicer this way. You can just see in the hole there it's just starting to cut. There's a couple of spots where it's not. You just need to continue just very gently. You finish the reamer stroke, but you don't finish it letting the cut stop abruptly. It needs to cut really, finish really smoothly. Again, this one is a little, we just keep coming it back out every time it catches, just to let it start slowly taking the high spots off. You start to feel that's cutting smoothly the whole way around now. There's a couple of high spots in this one. Just need to come down, and it's now cutting evenly. Very similar sort of arrangement when you're cutting the pegs and you're not really cranking them in. Just letting the cutter, just let the cutter do its job. Just run it up to that collar. No, it keeps the collar intact. Otherwise, if you didn't run a blade around this edge, it would most likely just chip straight through the collar. Now, this being the thinnest one, we can pretty much be guaranteed we're going to need to go down to the next size. Cutter block, hole on the cutter block, but we always check just to make sure. We should know that there, so that's again, we will cut down. See, that just chips up through our collar nicely without breaking the collar. Okay, so got all the pegs fitting. Next is to do some final sort of fitting. You can just give the pegs a turn in the spot and take them out. You can either touch it to your lip to feel the hot spots where it's warm. Or if you actually look at it in the light, you can see whether there's any high spots where it's shiny. It's a little bit more shiny just here. This top one here looks quite good. It's quite even all the way around. It's a couple of high spots just high spots down. The top one there is quite good. Run it around again. Much touching all the way around now, that one. It's just a final. Happy with those there. Next up is to mark out the position for the string holes, drill the string holes and finish them off.